bless you. Welcome to Jesus the Rock Church. We're going to start our annual Bible study. God bless you for joining us this wonderful day. We left off in Matthew, verse 21. So today we're going to do Matthew chapter 1, verses 22 and verses 23. Thank you very much for joining us. Shout out to everyone out there. Hopefully you're being blessed by the word. Hallelujah. Praise God for the time that you put into it. Hopefully you have read ahead. So let's dig in. We're going to begin with verse 22 and 23, which says, "All this happened so that what the Lord had spoken through the prophet came true. The virgin will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and they will name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. Hallelujah. So, in your Bibles, if you want to grab your pens or highlighters, underline Emmanuel and underline God is with us. Hallelujah. So, it was terribly difficult for Jewish people to refrain from linking God's covenant with the prosperity or fate of their nation. Nevertheless, the prophetic testimony of Jeremiah heralds a new covenant, God's promise to write his word on the hearts of his people. The nation would fade in its significance, but God would instill his precepts in those individuals who sought him. Jeremiah chapter 31, verses 31 through 34. Hallelujah. He writes it on our tablets of our heart. No one in the factories, the little boxes on their head or on their hand. Hallelujah. See, Matthew, after a full revelation of Christ's genealogy and his unique conception in Mary, the chosen vessel, now called forth the first Old Testament prophecy that would validate the present circumstances in the midst of his Jewish readers. Hallelujah. He quoted Isaiah, one of the foremost and most revered prophets of their heritage. "So the Lord himself will give you this sign. A virgin will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and he will name him Emmanuel, God is with us." Isaiah 7, verses 14. While this seems humanly impossible, Matthew's narrative affirms that God was the author of these extraordinary circumstances. Praise the Lord. More significantly, it revealed a truth that is repeated numerous times throughout the scripture. That is, that God reached down to humanity. Humans would never reach up to find God. In order to fulfill God's purpose in saving people from their sins, it was fundamentally necessary that the Creator enter his own creation and dwell among the people who were in such desperate need for his salvation. This truth is embodied in both names, Jesus and Emmanuel, given to the child born to Mary. Hallelujah. So as we enter this Christmas season, remember, Mary was a chosen vessel, not the vessel. Remember, Mary, in the lineage, without sin and humble, became the chosen person to bring in this man, God, into the world. We are to seek Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ only. We don't pray to Mary, we pray to Jesus. We pray to the Father. We pray to the Holy Spirit. Okay? Mary is nothing more than a human being, just like you and I. Okay? We can thank Mary, we can just reverence Mary for the role she played in keeping her son safe from the evil that wanted to destroy our Savior, our King. Hallelujah. Mary went through the torment and torture watching her child crucified, flogged, whipped, beaten, punched, kicked. Mary did not have it easy, but she fulfilled the call of God in her life. and her call was to bring a child into the world that would be the Savior. You and I are called. We are called to do things in our life that may not be easy. But we do not pray to you or I. We do not pray to Mary. We pray to Jesus, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. So remember that this Christmas. Remember Emmanuel, God with us, for us, not against us. And He loves you because Jesus is Lord. Why? Because He is. I'll see you next time. Continue reading ahead, brothers and sisters. I praise you for joining our Bible study, verse by verse, line by line, precept by precept. God bless you. Peace.